mediocre people are brainwashed to live a mediocre life and die in a middle age 150 years. 150 years is a middle age. And if you die 100 years, by 100, you died very young. Untimely death. This eating every day itself is a mediocre lifestyle. You have been brainwashed. The great saint from the Shaivite tradition, Thiruvalluvar, he says beautifully, Marundena vendavam yakkaikku arundiyadu atradu potri unin. You don't need any medicine for your body if you just know whatever you took inside has already left your body and then take the next meal or food. Marundena vendavam yakkaikku arundiyadu atradu potri unin. Whatever you eat, make sure it already left your body. You are clean, fresh. Then take the next meal. I tell you, you are what you eat. You are what you eat. So be extremely sincere. Extremely sincere about what you eat. Next, always have higher intention for your fasting. See the parasites and microbes in your body are more powerful than your mental intentions, than your sankalpa. But if you make your sankalpa as Shiva sankalpa, for example, if you do intermittent fasting for the sake of health, I challenge you will fail. I have seen enough people trying and failing. Because the parasites sitting inside your stomach, the kind of the visualization they release when the hunger chemicals are activated in the body, the kind of the visual picture about the food items they release in your brain, you just forget all your intermittent fasting. You simply eat only after you finish eating, you start repenting, oh God, I drank high sugar juices. I tell you, this parasites and microbes sitting inside your stomach, the kind of the visualization they release inside your brain and break your sankalpa, your resolution. and forcibly make you eat, you will come back to your sense only after you eat. So this intermittent fasting ideas do not work. Make your sankalpa into Shiva sankalpa by making the fasting as vrata. See, you are feeling connection with Paramashiva. It'll have many layers of your emotions associated with it. The intensity of your relationship with Paramashiva, it'll have love, it'll have little even fear, it'll have some kind of a devotion, begging, prayer, greed, fear, so many, almost all emotions mixed together. Use the strength of your relationship with Paramashiva for empowering your sankalpa. That is what is called mama sankalpam shiva sankalpamastu. Making my sankalpa into shiva sankalpa. Use your relationship with Paramashiva to strengthen your conscious resolution. That is what is making your sankalpa into shiva sankalpa.